When the planes are parked up and London is asleep, a secret army is on the move. We filmed it from Heathrow Airport's own spotter plane at the dead of night. The lights on the runway below are part of a massive operation that will only be heard of if it goes wrong, which is never so far. 5 nights a week from 10 p.m. until 5 a.m, a team of 150 well-disciplined men and 50 massive pieces of equipment move in to rebuild the 2-mile-long runway that is the heart of Heathrow.
Well, it is a fairly complex project. It does require an awful lot of careful planning and control, almost along the lines of a military operation. We take possession of the runway at 10 o'clock each night, and all work has to be finished at 5 o'clock to allow an hour for a thorough inspection and sweeping prior to opening at 6.
The contractors renew an average of 400 feet, 150 feet wide every night. It requires enormous precision, as well as hundreds of tons of top quality asphalt, to ensure the runway is handed back smooth as a die and perfectly clear of debris at 5 a.m. An hour later, the giant jets are once again landing and taking off on the new surface. How important is tidiness on the runway when you finish each night?
It is vital. Even the smallest stone could be a problem for an aircraft engine, and that's why we have such a thorough inspection each morning before the runway opens.
When the southern runway is completed in December, the boys from the Black Stuff will be turning their hands to Heathrow's northern runway. You'll only hear about it if they don't finish on time and planes are delayed, and that doesn't seem likely. Meanwhile, the Civil Aviation Authority say the construction team should be turning their attention to building a brand new runway for London. In their annual report out today, they say a new runway will be necessary within 20 years to handle all the extra traffic. It's a controversial view that will annoy many people who live around Heathrow and Gatwick. Simon Neave at what is already the world's busiest international airport for Thames News.